The Joel Fernandes Show is a talk show channeled spontaneously from Source to edify and help raise the vibrations of truthers, starseeds, Christic alchemists, and others who have seen through this illusionary matrix into messianic consciousness by discussing hidden knowledge, higher dimensions, and manifesting so that we can shine our light for everyone to see and co-create the earth that we know we actually deserve to live in. Don't! I gotta go! I'm working on the show! Welcome everybody to the Joel Fernandes Show! I'm Joel Fernandes. And I'm just enjoying a bit of melon for breakfast. I'm gonna just chilling out because today's another hot day, and as soon as I'm done this, I'm gonna get right to work. So let's dig in. I got my trusty melon scooper spoon here. It's not even 10 o'clock and it's already 30 degrees here in Calgary. It's going to be another hot day.
That was good. That was good. Now to get to work. So we are back in Studio A, and while we got one of these shows exporting, I'm going to be working on this crest. And I'm going to be digitizing that, and that's going to be made into a poster, and that's going to be replacing that flag right up there. It's going to be a big banner covering the whole wall. But yeah, I got my trusty Wacom tablet here and a couple blueberries. I don't really eat that much when I'm really getting in the zone and drawing, but we're going to get to work right away on that. And that's pretty much going to take most of the day. So we're going to have another very productive day once again. Let's get right into it, shall we? Okay, so this crest is a development of something that really started very simple, just as this logo. This logo actually is the logo for a community that came to me in, well, a series of events, but it's basically an artistic community where artists can be themselves and really create the world that, well, we know we're deserving of, like I say all the time. And yeah, the eagle is based on the United States eagle, but as you see on his wings, there's 14 little squares. Those are going to be icons of each of the little sub-communities, if you will. Each of those sub-communities represent a different aspect of a society that's functioning in holistic mode. So these parts of the community actually are like the food processing, but this is basically like just the crest for that whole society. On the bottom, here's the scroll that says Holy Bat El Rum, which literally means Rome has fallen. And it's flanked by this man who's pouring water from a pitcher. And that has its own story with the society. Whoops, what was that? And that story itself is actually a recipe veiled in symbolism that tells you how to create this sacred anointing oil. But that's a story for a whole other episode. But on the other side, I have this ox, and the ox is also one of the four creatures. So we have the eagle, the man, the ox, and above that we have the lion. We'll get to that in a bit. But these are literally the four fixed signs of the zodiac, and they also represent the four creatures around the throne room. Here we have the lion, and the lion is literally a manifested fire. Now, this lion is actually drawn in symbolism, which I saw during my near-death experience, when I literally experienced the transcendence, who has literally appeared as a burning flame of fire from the waist up and from the waist down, sitting on this throne, seated above a sea of literally rippling lapis lazuli that itself was alive. Like this whole scene, everything was alive. And flanked around this throne were pillars, as you see here. And each of these pillars was a different gemstone. Like there was amethyst, there was ruby, there was sapphire, there was emerald. It was literally all kinds, and I believe there were 12, but I didn't really catch it because there was so much going on in this scene, and literally everything was alive. Even the rainbow was alive, and it wasn't just horizontal colors. The colors transitioned as you went around it, but these were colors that we don't have in this dimension, so I literally couldn't convey that in this drawing. Because not even all the colors that we have in this earth plane can be printed on print. If you know about CMYK and RGB colors and all those different gamuts, I mean, that's a whole other science in and of itself. Like, literally, you can't print a neon color unless you have neon ink and you're using a paper that will reflect that kind of light, maybe even printing on metal. But like I said, that's a whole other science, and I don't know if I'll talk about that in a future episode, but... But moving on, we just have like a back scene with curtains and mountains and sunshine. And it's literally just framing this whole kind of essence. And as you can see, these curtains also have rims wherewith they're inlaid with eyes all around. And this is one of the aspects of the creatures surrounding this transcendent throne. They literally have eyes all within them. And these are not just eyes the way you and I have eyes. Like, these eyes are huge and they're rolling about within and without them. And it's something like, they don't look like any creatures that we can compare with on this earth. But yeah, they do have faces, and there's like one with the face of a lion, one with the face of a man, the eagle and the ox. So this symbolism I had to include in this crest, because literally this crest is basically me trying to create a shadow of the expression of what I saw. It's not the full thing. It cannot even come near to the full thing. But this is about as close as I can get to in just a simple drawing. And here we have these wheels that look like gyroscopes. Literally, this is where the awareness of the beings that surround the throne are embodied. And a lot of people compare these to UFOs, but UFOs are just a symbol of this thing. And UFOs are used by the Dark Kingdom much more frequently than we'd expect. Because these beings, they don't require vehicles. They can literally move at will wherever they want. It's the beings that manipulate us that come in these various apparitions. And they like to usurp our own awareness so that we will literally give them credence and give them authority over our own experience. And that's when they step in and really start to manipulate us on a different level. But I don't really want to talk about that. Here we have the line art all finished, and now I'm going to start coloring it. So all these colors are symbolic also. They all represent different things in not only symbolism, but also in the community. But this part, I'm coloring it this way instead of doing the quick and easy shortcut of just select the white space and fill, because I do want to make it bleed under the black line and create full color spectrum, because I will be blowing this image up, like I said, to fit the whole wall, or not the whole wall, but at least a 2x3 size poster. The eagle itself represents the community for the artist, and both the man and the ox also symbolize different aspects of the logos. And yeah, there's a mini rainbow here that exemplifies the bigger rainbow. And of course, the lion, which is made out of fire, symbolizes the transcendent logos, you know. But yeah, this guy that's pouring the water, literally everything in the story is a symbol. And if you take the story as it goes on, it actually spells out how to create this recipe of a concoction based in oil, but that actually can be used, like the ancient rite of the Israelites with their anointing oil, to really receive this transcendent spirit in you and manifest it through you. Thank you. So I'm just clearing up some of the lines there and now coloring the lion. And that sash that he's wearing is actually a reference to Revelation, when Christ literally comes in his triumphant to decimate the evil forces once and for all. And it says he's wearing a robe dipped in blood. So there's a lot of symbolism that a lot of churchgoers don't even like getting into. But like I said, I'm really exposing all of what they've been hiding and showing the truth for what it is. Because honestly, they've been sitting on a gold mine this whole time. And they don't own truth. They don't have a monopoly on people's souls. Literally, this stuff is transcendent, and we can all tap in and start to manifest from that state of being whereby literally Source is creating things through us. I mean, that's what it's all about, right? That's what it's all about. So right now I'm just coloring in the curtains, and this part takes a little longer than I expected. Actually, this drawing did take a little longer than I expected because I did something very dumb, and that was merge all the lines into one layer. It would have actually been much quicker if I kept them separate, and then I could actually just change the colors of each line. But because I merged them, I had to do a masking for each segment of the line when I changed the line color. But we'll get to that in a bit here. Right now I'm still just doing the base colors. So what I do for coloring is I just do a base color, and then I change the color of the lines surrounding each color so that, you know, they're not just black. And then I do a highlighted color, and then I do a shading color. And if I need more than just one or two highlights or shades, then I'll do that as well. But for the most part, I just do one highlight, one shade. But yeah, right now just filling in this background, which, like I said, would have been much quicker if I didn't merge those lines together. But still, by dedicating myself for this whole day, I was able to finish this drawing in a day, which I didn't actually expect to finish. But yeah, I guess when Source is working through you, like, these things happen. And yeah, these are just the folds in the sheet. I will be changing those colors later on. Sometimes it's easier to paint with a darker color and then just change it later so that you can actually see where you're painting, especially if it's like a really light white or like a really light yellow or something like that. Okay, so these are the icons that actually represent each of the different segments of the society. And I just copy-pasted that because I already drew them in the map of the society, which I made quite a while ago, actually. And now I'm just coloring in the mountains. Get that looking all nice and good. And we got two forms of lightning on either side, because there's literally like electricity radiating from this throne at all times. It's quite the sight. I'm sure there are prophets out there that have seen this on a regular basis, but when I saw it, I was just like dumbfounded. Literally, this thing was beyond me. And some of these creatures, mind you, like, it's easy to say, oh, there's this angel or that angel, but when you actually come face to face with them, they're not like humans. Like, sometimes they'll appear as humans to make themselves more palatable to our consciousness. But man, these beings are on another class altogether. And that's not to say they're higher than us. Actually, in our original state, we are higher than the angels. And we can actually command them, even in this state right now, if we come at them with the authority of the living logos, they're actually at our command. A lot of people will look to angels or these etheric beings as authorities, but really we are the authority, and we can actually tell them what to do, where to go, what to fight for, what to accomplish on our behalf. So it's quite amazing when you really tap into your full potential in Christ, in the living logos. And of course, that's what this whole crest is trying to represent. And at the top here, I have text that says, "This is the likeness of the glory of Yahweh." And that's not even the fullness of it. That's just a fraction, like a shadow of what it completely represents. So there we have the full colored version. And
actually, you know what? I'm going to go off and make a smoothie. So we're going to do that right away and get right back to work.
So now that we had that smoothie and we're back, we're just going to do some of these line colorings. I don't remember what the technical term for this kind of line is, but basically just shaded lines in the same hue as the base color that it's surrounding. But yeah, for the most part, it just kind of gives it more of a 3D look than a cartoonish look. I mean, these are still 2D drawings, but you know, it makes it a little more 3D-ish. And yeah, obviously this part of the process would have been much quicker if each of these lines was kept on a separate layer. I could literally just change the hues for all of these. But for whatever reason, like, I've been rusty with this whole kind of thing. I haven't done this kind of art for a little while. So when I merged all these layers together, I didn't really anticipate that I would have to do it this way after. And honestly, I wish I hadn't, because that would have saved me probably a couple hours, actually, just coloring these lines in. But it's all good, because taking time to color the lines in also gives you time to kind of gauge where the picture is going. If you color the whole thing too fast, a lot of times you don't change colors where they could be different. And then when you go back after you're done, you could say, oh, this color would have looked better this way. But with that all being said, I mean, this very drawing just manifested like amazingly. Just literally just kind of fell out of the sky. Not to be figurative, but it almost felt that way. Like, it was just downloaded to me. In an evening, I drew the sketch for this. I literally drew the sketch out for this whole crest in one evening. And then it just took it from there. I wasn't even planning on doing this. Actually, what I wanted to do for the wall in the studio was actually draw, like, what it would look like if I looked out of the window from this community, from like my own house on the hilltop, and actually see the community down in the valley and see it surrounded by like these forests and these fields, and see like these greenhouses out on the side, and I guess buildings surrounding this community, which literally has a river flowing through it. Like, it's an amazing scenery, and this river comes down from the mountains, and at the other end, on the other side of the community, there's like a paradisical island. So this scenery would have been pretty amazing to create, but that itself would have taken quite a bit of time, and I would actually have to use a 3D rendering program to kind of get the picture for that. So that wouldn't be done nearly as quickly as this crest, but who knows? That idea was for the backdrop of the studio. This is not going to be on the backdrop of the studio. And even the calendar, like, I wanted to keep the calendar as a backdrop for the studio, but honestly, there was no room for it after I changed it up with the paintings. And so I just kept that in Studio B. But honestly, that calendar hasn't gone anywhere. And literally, Source is downloading to me more things of what to do with that calendar. Like, Tropical Zodiac has its own kind of understanding of the pulse of time, the pulse from like sunrise to noon to sunset to midnight. And you know, even that's fractalized in the spring, the summer, the autumn, and the winter. Everything, literally everything in creation exemplifies this time wave. But from there, Source is really getting me to understand that, you know, Tropical Zodiac still calls the signs according to their constellational names, which literally is outdated because of precessional slippage. You know, we can't be ruled by that when we're already living in a new era. So Source showed me, like, count the year according to the constellations. And based on those constellations, whenever the sun is in a certain constellation, you call it by that name. But then Source is like, you know what? You gotta harmonize the constellations with where they are now, with how this pulse manifests in all creation. You know, literally the sign of Aries, which embodies that dawning, is no longer at the tropical point in Aries. It's now in Taurus. So we have to harmonize the constellation with the tropical segment of that sine wave. And that's what Source has shown me. And yes, while you divide the tropical sine wave into 12 equal parts, the constellations are by no means equidistant. So each constellational month has its own number of days. Like Virgo has 51 days in it, while Libra has 17 days. So we can't like be ruled by these, you know, 30 days. That's totally arbitrary. That's Gregorian calendar based. Of course, it has its origins with the lunar calendar. But when you actually follow the phases of the moon, you realize that in a lunar calendar, you're not dealing with the same months every year. So you have to adjust, you have to have leap months, and there's a whole other process for that. And that's all well and good, that's part of the calendar, but we have to understand the calendar for what it is and not create an arbitrary man-made calendar. Make our own time, basically. Source has a timeline, and Source has a way of bringing all of this to pass. So we have to literally know how Source is doing this. And when we know how Source does it, we can literally manifest from that state of being for ourselves. So now I'm starting to shade this drawing, and now I'm putting in some of these lighter highlights. I'm starting with the highlights, and then I'm just going to take it from there. And once I'm done everything with highlights, I'm going to go over it with shadows, and that's pretty much it. That's pretty much my drawing process. So yeah, if you can see on the rims, some of these highlights don't follow the edges and, you know, where you'd anticipate shadows, because we're talking, you know, some of these things are shiny. But, you know, different types of shadows, different types of highlights for different types of material. That's, you know, basic in art. Yeah, highlighting the icons as if they're like little badges, little buttons, and highlighting the feathers, that takes time, always takes time, but feathers look awesome when you get them right. I'm still learning. I'm literally an amateur artist. Like, I did some art in high school, and I did architecture in college, but just kind of learning art on my own. Like, I've never had formal training in art, but if I never did architecture, I would have gone to art school, and that would have lined up, but the school I went to just fudged around with the curriculum, and, you know, it wasn't 100% what I'd like it to be, but even that was a growth process, and in retrospect, I know that it taught me things that I needed to know about the world, and actually gave me a thicker skin wherewith I can deal with more of this stuff. So I'm grateful even for those things. Like, Source lines up all things for our benefit, especially when we're walking with Source and not trying to figure out this world from our own physical ego. But Source is literally transcendent, and that's what I'm trying to convey with this imagery. I'm literally trying to show the magnitude of what I saw in my near-death experience, if you would call it that. But literally, this is all symbolism for what I experienced. It's not even what I saw. Like, what I saw was more real than, you know, symbolism. But yeah, like, what we're talking about when we talk about the living logos, we're talking about a force that, yes, it manifested as a physical being. Yes, it manifested as a text. Yes, it manifests as all these things, because it's something more than all of this. It transcends this physical dimension, and it literally has the power to not only influence this dimension, but literally create in this dimension. So I'm going to leave the commentary there. And just as I'm finishing up coloring, I'm going to leave you with one of these songs from David Koresh, where he quotes a lot from the scriptures. And this one is called From the Rising of the Sun.
See the sun rising as the prince Remixes and the coming of Salaam and beat. Like the lightning from the east, the shine is to the west. So share the coming of Salaam and beat. He is coming on a cloud with a trumpet in his hand, is sounding loud. And the dead whom Christ shall appear. He is coming on the throne. When and all, he'll take you home. Don't you want to see him when he appears? From the rising of the sun to the going down thereof, to share the coming of Son of Man be. Like the lightning from the east, the shining to the west, so share the coming of Son of Man be.
So we got that done, and you know what? It's been an amazingly hot day. It literally got over 40 degrees today, but there's still about an hour left until sunset, so I'm gonna go out there, get some air, and enjoy that great summer sun. So I'll check in with you guys in a bit. So it's the end of another great productive day, and a beautiful, beautiful summer day here in Calgary. It's like we've had some amazing weather this last week, and it's just soaking it in, you know, getting that beautiful sunlight. And it's a beautiful, like, pink sky tonight. What's that old saying? It's like red sky in the morning, shepherd's warning, red sky at night, sailor's delight. And yeah, there's literally like not a cloud in the sky. Not a single cloud in the sky. It's just amazing. And now that drawing's all done, like literally, I didn't even think I'd be finished today, but it's amazing just how much work you can do if you just dedicate yourself and just focus. You know, put that time aside and really spend it in quality time. Like, you can accomplish anything. So I'm going to be taking that poster to the print shop. Probably going to get my friend to print it, but we'll see. I might even go to Staples and get it done professionally on some glossy stock and put that up on the wall. That's going to be like the frontispiece or the mantle or whatever you call it for the room. But it's just amazing. Like, things have come together so quickly, and it's just like one thing after the other just keeps unfolding. And that's really the way life should be. Like, for all of us. For all of us. Life is amazing. Isn't it amazing? And it shouldn't be anything less than that. So yeah, what's unfolded for me in this last little while, like, I want for everybody else. Like, I know everybody else might not be on board, but really, you all deserve it. We all deserve it. And once we tap into that, we can actually not only influence our own lives, but we influence the world around us. That's what it's all about. We're here to literally create heaven on earth. To be the agents in place for the kingdom of heaven and bring that into reality for those around us. Literally create a utopia for us and for future generations. I'm gonna get that poster printed tomorrow and, you know, just update y'all from there. So I'm just gonna enjoy the sunset, guys, and we'll continue the show tomorrow. I'm probably gonna do the unveiling of that in a future Joel Fernandez show, so stay tuned for that. That being said, I'm actually gonna end this show here. It actually was a long one just doing all this work. I'm gonna take today easy, you know, just maybe do a reasoning sesh and take it from there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Keep your vibe high and tune into Source, because Source is the only place where you'll actually find this kind of energy flow through you that actually allows you to manifest your talents, your dream life, and the utopia that we all know we've come here to deserve. So I love you guys. I'm gonna get going. I'm actually gonna be making an amazing tofu stir fry, something really simple, but just with some mixed veggies, some tofu, put some liquid aminos on that, and sprinkle it with some sesame seeds. Perfect. Oh, and you can't forget the minced garlic. Never thought I'd be saying that, guys, but here I am, you know. As my vibration raises, it just keeps raising and raising, and I shed old things and I take on new things. And literally, it's been an amazing journey. So keep the faith, stay optimistic, and keep manifesting this high vibe tribe. I'll check you in the next video. Joel signing out once again. Agape, salaam, namaste, hotep.